Hello, in this episode I'll explain why this key, the tab key, is so important for making the web accessible. I'm Eric Eggert, a web accessibility expert. You can follow me as Yatil, Y-A-T-I-L, on social media. If you have questions about this or other videos or want to propose a topic, use the hashtag AskYatil on Twitter. Keyboard Accessible Guideline 2.1 is one of the most important guidelines in WCAG 2. All functionality on a website or in an app must be available from a keyboard. This allows users to use your website or application without using a mouse or another pointer, for example, the finger on touchscreens. Why is this important? Many users of assistive technologies use the keyboard to interact with a website. For example, screen reader users usually use the keyboard to navigate around a page when they are on a computer. On mobile, often no physical keyboard is used, but it can be, but the gestures are translated to keyboard input. One could say that keyboard input is used like an API between the website or app and the assistive technology. WCAG 2 and keyboard interaction. WCAG has 6 success criteria on levels A and AA, covering the bulk of keyboard interaction. 2.1.1 keyboard makes sure that all interactions are available to keyboard users, with some exceptions that cover painting or other interaction where the timing of pressing keystrokes is essential. The example named is a helicopter model simulation. 2.1.2, no keyboard trap, protects users from getting stuck while using the keyboard to navigate through the page. 2.1.4, character key shortcuts, prevents single key presses to initiate an action. In addition to those 3 main success criteria, WCAG also has some rules that talk about focus, that is the place of the specific element that a user has navigated to. For orientation purposes, 2.4.3 focus order makes sure that the order of the focus makes sense for the content. 2.4.7 focus visible allows users to quickly identify where they are on the page. Note that the exact nature of visibility is not defined here. It'll be precisely defined in WCAG 2.2. Click the subscribe button and the notification bell to get informed once WCAG 2.2 is available and I release a video about the new requirements. Last but not least, 3.2.1 on focus makes sure that the website or application does not trigger an action just for navigating to a certain item. How does keyboard interaction work? After loading a page, pressing the tab key navigates to the first focusable element on the page. Not all elements on the page can be navigated to using the keyboard, as that would be very cumbersome for users. Instead, only interactive elements like links, buttons, or input elements are considered focusable by default. Once a focusable element is selected, it gets in the focused state. Screen readers read the focus name's accessible name and role. On most operating systems and browsers, the current position of the focus is by default indicated by an outline, which is a special type of border or a colored focus ring. When the focus is on a text field, a cursor is placed into the field, indicating that you can start typing. Note how nothing on the page changes just by using the tab key to focus around and explore the page. You can go back to the previous focused item by holding Shift and pressing the tab key. Once you arrive at interactive elements, you have 2 choices to activate them. Most elements, like links, are activated simply by pressing the Return or Enter keys. Buttons and checkboxes activate when you press the space bar. On input fields, Return or Enter should submit the form. A group of radio buttons is considered as one interactive element, so they have 1 collective tab stop in the focus order. Like select boxes, the arrow keys are used to make a selection. To allow users to know where they are on the page, a prominent outline should be displayed. This focus indicator should be more prominent than equivalent hover states, as you generally look in the direction you move your mouse, but the focus can jump around significantly and unexpectedly. What are the most common issues with keyboard interaction? Most issues stem from an interpretation of the web as a purely visual medium. Many designers do not design for anything else but mouse interaction because that is what they use all day. That often means hover styles for mouse users are defined, but focus styles are forgotten. Often it is sufficient to reuse the hover styles as a focus indicator. In addition, many developers do not use appropriate HTML elements for interactive elements. It happens quite frequently that a div element is used instead of a link or a button, which means that it's not in the focus order. While it is possible to retroactively add keyboard functionality and semantics to divs, it's usually easier to just use a button instead. Sometimes the default focus outline is considered as ugly or not fitting the design and therefore removed. I would recommend finding a visually nice focus style and use that instead. Notice that the default focus can be considered invisible in some cases. For example, in Firefox, the black dotted outline is almost impossible to see when the background of the focused element is dark. Avoid outline zero or outline none in your CSS at all cost. They remove the outline, which indicates the keyboard focus altogether. Your website is then not navigable by keyboard anymore. Usually I recommend using a high contrast color and at least a 2 or 3 pixel thick outline so that the indicator is easy to see. Using outline offset in CSS, you can have some distance between the outline border and the focused element. Keyboard traps rarely occur these days, but they can still happen. If you use JavaScript to manipulate the focus, watch out for them. To conclude, make sure your content is reachable using the keyboard by frequently testing that you can reach all interactive elements. Use standard elements so users can use learned interaction patterns with links, buttons, and other form elements. Use a prominent focus style that makes it easy for users to see where they are on the page. Stay tuned to learn more about web accessibility on my channel. Make sure to click subscribe and hit the notification bell icon to not miss anything. And of course, you can support me on Patreon at patreon.com/yatil or follow me at twitter.com/yatil. That's YATIL, where you can send me questions using the Ask Yatil hashtag. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.